shit. Well. Anyway, hey everyone, it's me, Cooper, again. I know those of you who are watching this on the Archives of Justin TV or on YouTube that this is being released a hell of a lot sooner than the rest of the Let's Play World of Warcraft series, which is incredibly bad and stupid, but still moderately funny. Anyway, I just felt like making a quick little update about, a thing I discovered earlier today when my friend, server changed, to Horde, which I will upload eventually. I'll get around to it, but this is important shit. To those of you who don't know, Blizzard recently trademarked, Mists of Panderia as a thing, and at first, everyone thought that was complete bullshit, because it was like, they're like, what's that? You know, this doesn't exist, this is bullshit, and then people found out that that was a real trademark thing, and then people were like, oh my god, what the fuck, is this a new expansion, new book, or anything? And it actually might be a new expansion. I don't know how well you can see this, but, you know, well, I guess I could show by moving my mouse, but you see, goods and services, blah, 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 blah. Computer game software, computer game disc, blah, 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 blah. You know, so, Mists of Panderia might be, you know, the new expansion. Because, you know, Blizzard pulls shit like this all the time before they're going to announce a new expansion. Like, same shit with Cataclysm. When Cataclysm was going to be announced, they trademarked Cataclysm. And everyone was just like, right before the BlizzCon, too. Mists of Panderia is being trademarked right before BlizzCon. You know, I'm just saying, coincidence much. And for fucking computer game software. Anyway, I'm just trying to point this out, like, I know that this is well known to the public, but I'll get into it deeper, so keep on watching. I'm not just being a, oh my god, super secret shit I just learned. No, I knew about this for a couple days, but anyway, there's something really important shit I found out today, as I said earlier, and that is actually within the throne room of Garrosh Hellscream, the new leader of the, you know, Horde. As you can see right here, okay, Felguard, the GTFO of Rug, only I can see him, Rug. Go over there, boy. There we go. Anyway, as you can see on the map, there we go, better. Once again, as we can see on the map, we have Kalimdor and shit over here, Northrend up top, and Eastern Kingdoms over the right. And then we have a Horde symbol down here, where the Southern Seas are. And, Blizzard has stated before that they wanted to go to, like, Zandalari, Kul'Thras, Undermine, shit like that before, as in, like, an actual expansion, and it's all in the South Sea area, where the Horde Mark is. And now, where Panderia is, where the Pandarian Brewmaster Brohams are, the Pan people, pretty much, live. No one knows, because it's surrounded by mist, and no one can ever find it. But I have a feeling it's probably around there, because it's probably going to be in an island expansion, which Blizzard seems like they want to do. I'm getting, like, the island idea expansion, and the fact that they got the Undermines and shit from the Jesse Cox video of them, you know, just theory crafting and shit for a good hour. Like, you should watch it if you haven't seen it. It gets into some deep-ass shit. Anyway, this isn't supposed to be a response to that or anything, but it's just the kind of little cute thing I found after watching that video and shit, that the Horde symbol would coincidentally, in quotation marks, my air quotation marks just can't see, in the same location of the islands that Blizzard have said that they want to go to and see and shit. And I have a feeling Panderia is probably in the Southern Seas, where all those other islands are. So I'm just saying, probably a coincidence, but I'm just saying, if it's a coincidence, it's one hell of a coincidence, and I'm saying, fucking, this might be some real ass shit, man. Because they've featured the Pandarians before. For all of you who quested back in vanilla of World of Warcraft, like I have, if you were Horde, well, actually, no, I don't know if you had to be Horde for that, but I've just always been Horde. You can get this thing called Chen's, Keg or some shit, and it involved Ratchet and the Barons and shit. And basically, it featured Chen's Storm Snout, or whatever, a Panderian Brewmaster who is some type buds and shit with the Horde. And it features, I think you remake the his famous brew or something. I don't know. I haven't done, you know, obviously it's Cataclysm. I haven't done that quest in forever because I haven't leveled anyone ever since Cataclysm came out, since Cataclysm made it easy. And Recruited Friend got bumped up to 80, so it's actually worthwhile now. So yeah, the Panderias have been featured before in Warcraft. Ooh, and the companion pet, the Panderian Monk. That's in Warcraft 2. As in, I mean, not Warcraft 2, but as in World Warcraft. So I'm just saying, you know, either these are a hell of a string of coincidences, or Blizzard... I doubt the quest was... I presume the quest is an Easter egg, because there's no way they planned this all this out, because... Anyone who played Vanilla WoW, there was no plot. It was just like, alright, here's our world, here's some shit to do, go do shit. And they were like, oh fuck, if we want to keep making money, we gotta have a story. Because you can't really just have a game like that without a story. It's just like, what compels you to do these things? You gotta have a story. So I presume the fucking Chen Storm Snap thing was an Easter egg, because that was since Vanilla. But with the Panderian Monk, and now... Miss of Pandaria being trademarked before Cataclysm, and I presume this Horde symbol map thing has been here since the start of Cataclysm. I don't know. I've never paid attention to it before because it's like one of those things you don't notice until something around you changes.